Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at everything solar. I'm Warren, and with me today is Larry, and we're going to talk about the truth about batteries, how many batteries you need, what different types of loads you could run off those batteries, and how long you can run those loads for. You know, Larry, many times people think they're going to get battery backup and they're going to be able to be off-grid and just live life like they normally do, run their AC, do their laundry, run their refrigerator, and they think they can do that for $15,000 or $20,000. So help us get an understanding of the reality of what you get for your money and what loads you can back up.
Yes, our basic system comes in at right around that 20,000 range, 20 to 25.
Yeah.
And what that's gonna do for you typically for most households, it's gonna be refrigerator, well pump, and lighting. That's about what that's going to get you. So what we recommend is that you install a separate critical loads panel, backed up loads panel, where you tie in those three loads or maybe a few additional loads, and then that's all you're backing up during an outage.
Let's say you want something more than just one or two appliances for a few hours, and you want to be able to last a few days and run more of your appliances. What are you looking at?
So you have a couple options at that point. One is adding a lot of batteries.
Yeah.
And there we might be talking about 100,000, we might be talking about 150,000 or even more, depending on the size of your house.
Yeah.
A second option that we often recommend is installing some kind of load control system, a system that will kick off your larger loads during a grid outage. For example, if you kick off HVAC and hot water heating during an outage, you can save a lot of battery power and really stretch out that use for a longer period of time.
So if you're adding on these components to be able to shed these loads or get rid of these loads when the power goes out, what does that look like in terms of cost? How does that increase the cost of a project?
So if you're okay with doing it for maybe 12 of your circuits, that's gonna cost in the $3,000 to $3,500 range. If you wanna do it for your entire breaker panel, we're probably looking at more like $5,000. But if you control 12 of your loads, that's gonna go a long way for your battery system.
What would you say to people though, Larry, who would think, you know what, why would I wanna spend $3,000 or $5,000 extra to have that load management? Why can't I just go off and turn off the breakers as the power goes out and turn those appliances off?
It's a great question. You can do that. We don't recommend it for most customers because most customers aren't going to be that hands-on. They wanna know that when I leave on vacation and the power goes out, I don't need to manually be flipping breakers. I don't need to go down to the cold, dark basement or have somebody come over and do that for me. But we do have customers that are willing to be more hands-on, and they understand what power the loads take, and they're willing to do that.
And in addition, if those loads exceed the capacity of the inverter, it might shut down the inverter and turn that off as well. So you may not have the opportunity to go and shut them off before the inverter shuts itself down.
Correct, yeah, if you have a lot of loads running, the power kicks off, you don't get down the basement fast enough,
yeah.
It could shut off your solar right now. It would try to start up again, but that would take some additional time.
Yeah. If you're interested to find out how many batteries you would need for your appliances for a certain amount of time, click on the link in the description below and it'll take you to our battery storage calculator, which will give you an estimate of how many batteries you'll need, how many inverters you'll need, and an estimated cost. So to wrap things up, for $15,000 or $20,000, you're not gonna get whole home backup. You will get a few appliances for several hours to get you through your average outage. If you want a longer period of time with more appliances, you could spend upwards of $100,000 into the few hundred thousand dollars to do that with battery backup. But there are appliances or devices that can help you shed some of those loads for a few thousand dollars to make it less, more cost effective and still be able to have a lengthier period of time and more appliances backed up.